Hey folks, it's Maxi here and welcome to another TEW 2020 video. You join us for the aftermath of All Out, as we are now embarking on a new road, a new journey towards next year's All Out, and one that's certainly going to have a lot of twists and turns along the way. Shouldn't be too long a video today, I'm a wee bit under the weather, but I want to keep playing TEW, so the show must go on, goddammit. But in all seriousness, there was obviously a review looking to go to two brands and two shows. I looked into it and I can confirm that won't be happening until 2022 in the game because of the collapse of the deal with ITV4 previously, which happened at the tail end of December last year. It means even American broadcasters won't speak to us until we get to a year over, so hopefully that'll be in the works for 2022. Regarding the AEW Knighthood pay-per-view that was going to happen, I think that event will still happen. But I think it will happen more likely in October and won't be like a pay-per-view, more like an event just exclusively for the people of the UK to see in-game. So we'll have probably, this can change week by week by the way, but we're looking to go Fighter Fest, AEW Knighthood, and then All Out of Control, or if I can think of a better pay-per-view name before then. But anyway, we either. Epic show last week in Dynamite. We had a fairly strong pay-per-view thanks to the boosts. Can we carry on in this new chapter of AEW Dynamite? Let's find out, shall we? So we're at the 5th Third Arena. We're in the Great Lakes region in front of 13,176 fans. As always, we have a couple of pre-show matches that we'll rattle through quickly. We had Ricky Starks defeat T-Hawk in 9:51 with the Buster Keaton. That was a 45. T-Hawk's 46 performance plays Ricky Starks 41. Good win for absolute Ricky Starks. Wardlow defeats Michael Nakazawa in 6:10 with Splash Mountain, a 56. We also had Brian Cage defeat QT Marshall in 8:32 with a flying elbow drop. This was a 61 rated matchup. Good win for the machine Brian Cage. We had Anna Jay, the star of the show, defeat Killer Kelly in 5:57 by pinfall. This was a 29, so we're slowly getting Anna Jay over, slowly but surely. We had Abaddon defeat Deonna Purrazzo in 7:26 by pinfall. This was a 30. Unfortunately, Deonna Purrazzo sustained a perforated eardrum, so it'll be interesting to see how long that keeps Deonna out for, but a good win regardless for Abaddon. And we had the debuting Brian Pillman Jr. defeat Jack Evans in 9:58. With a Tornado DDT. This was a 57 rated matchup. Brian debuts a loose cannon gimmick and they get an initial rating of adequate. Now the reason for signing Brian Pillman Jr, I would have liked to have just signed him in a handshake deal, but I believe MLW were trying to sign him on an exclusive written and I wanted him on board, so he's here. He's actually fairly over, actually sitting at around about 58 overness within the US. So that being said, yeah, he'll actually be fairly in a good position in the card. Not one a signing we wanted to make just now, but felt like it was necessary to make sure we didn't lose him down the line. So we start the show with Cody. He's hyping up on himself. This was an 81. Says it was a good victory for him over Rey Fénix. Disappointed what happened to Chris Jericho. And he just basically says, but tonight he'll get his match up with Pentagon and to make sure, you know, that he can get one up on both of the Lucha Brothers. He also explains what we've already talked about. He's delighted with how the year went, the wrestling year for AEW. So they're hoping they can expand on that into the next All Out. And he obviously mentions the fact they're looking at going to a second show. And we're looking to get some more global pay-per-views. But basically just him just doing his kind of corporate stuff for once. Just saying thank you and hopes everyone enjoys the show. So that was an 81 promo there. Only match of the night was terrible and had Bandido defeat Kip Sabian in 7:46 with the Revolution Fly. This was a 61, so pretty decent opener. 65 plays a 45. Bandido's getting better at his gimmick. Just a simple matchup showcasing his talents and giving him the victory. Backstage though, we have AJ Styles, who is looking at a monitor and he's a wee bit frustrated watching Bandido because Bandido did defeat him at All Out. And he also notices basically Brian Pillman Jr, who's just basically laughing at AJ. He gets a bit heated and Mick Foley goes, you know what, you used to can face each other next week on Dynamite if yous are going to keep this up, this bickering and arguing. No better way to sell it than in the ring. So straight in, we've got AJ Styles versus Brian Pillman Jr. Let me know who you think will win that one. That was a 71, so a fairly strong segment. Moving along, we had a tag team match, and it was the team of Mr. Brody Lee and John Silver, who defeated Sonny Kiss and Joey Janela, when Brody Lee defeated Sonny Kiss with a pile driver within 6:19. Brody was head and shoulders above the rest. I'm hoping that Mr. Brody Lee can carry John Silver, but a 62 is still good. Brody has got a gimmick that's getting stale, but we'll look to adjust that slightly in the future. Next person in the Dark Order to have a matchup was Priscilla Kelly, and she was in an abysmal matchup where she lost to Chris Statlander in 8:01. A 40 due to the injury, this probably would have pushed the 50s, but a sleepy head for Priscilla Kelly, so we'll see how long that takes her out of action. But a good win for the alien Chris Statlander, and maybe long term issues for Priscilla Kelly. After this, she's backstage alongside fellow Dark Order members Darby Allin, Stu Grayson, Evelyn O, John Silver and Brody Lee. This is a 61. Brody Lee just says, "Fucking excellent, Silver, we've won again. You keep this up and you'll go far in this place. Darby, you are phenomenal in what you've done at All Out. Priscilla, we need to get you winning. Don't sweat about it too much. I'll think of something and we'll make sure you can get some victories. We'll make sure that every member of the Dark Order, should you join us, is successful. That's what we do. We make people's lives better." So he's really intent of passing that message on. So that was a 61. We had the tag team match for the AEW World Tag Team titles, and it was a decent matchup that saw Santana and Ortiz defeat Luchasaurus and Jungle Boy in 8:29, and Santana pinned Luchasaurus. Obviously, it was a first defence for the Proud and Powerful tag team, giving them a win, 71. You can see there Santana and Ortiz with two very good performances. Another promo from MGF and Wardlow, and MGF says he showed how damn good he is when he defeated John Moxley. It's only a matter of time before he goes to the top. He's obviously was gutted that Wardlow got taken out, but he's good to know that Wardlow's fighting fit, he's back in action, and he feels like, do you know, there's a lot of kind of numbers games going about here, a lot of factions, and maybe, just maybe, MGF and Wardlow might need to find a friend or two. So that was an 84. We then cut backstage, and MGF, after the advert break, is on his phone, and he says, you fancy coming in, you fancy joining me and Wardlow? He's like, good. Might see you next week, might see you in a couple of weeks, but good to know you'd be interested in joining us. Speak to you soon. So a 73 for the promo there. Who could this mystery person be? Well, that will obviously take place over the upcoming few weeks. The end of the matchup, a bit disappointed this was only a 71. Maybe time constraints harmed it. But it was a good matchup, good wrestling, decent reaction from the crowd. Sammy Guevara defeats Chris Sabin in 8:16 with a 6:30. A 71, obviously, Sammy's so over in this. It was just a regular matchup. A few negatives regarding it, but yeah, I just wanted to see those two clash and continue Sammy's run of momentum. Moving on, promo from Dr. Britt Baker, DMD. Pretty standard Britt promo. She's just being very arrogant. She just says, "I'm back. Bit of a shame I didn't win the AEW Women's Championship, but it's just put a target on the back of Tony Storm. And I'm just going to show how damn good I am around here, including in this match coming up." So it was a 35. Her matchup was just a 27 because both of them aren't over. We obviously have to build it up with Dr. Britt Baker. So the performances were good. Great chemistry between her and Kylie Rae. Just neither have the overness at this particular time. But Britt Baker wins in 7:03 by pinfall. So a good win off the bat. Promo from Killer Cross. Only a 57 is really underwhelming, but he just says, "I've obviously noticed what Chris Jericho has been doing in AEW. I know that Chris Jericho is an absolutely massive name, and there is no thing I want to do than make my name off the spot. Make people know who the hell I am, stand up, take notice, and then just get to the top of AEW. If you can make a name off of Chris Jericho, Chris Jericho is going to just, you know, he's declining. He's getting worse by age. He's just going to be tick number one as I propel myself to the World Championship. So, disappointing with the promo. Can't wait for the match, Cross v Jericho, but 57, very happy with that. Or not very happy with, I should say. Pat comes out, just says it's good to be your new AEW champion. But obviously with that being the case, there's going to be a lot of people, I don't know why I've done the accent, who will be chasing after him and looking his belt. He's happy to take on any comer, but please be warned that he is a dangerous, dangerous man. And he will go to certain lengths to retain his championship. So in 82, Pat came out of it looking excellent. Also not his best promos, only in the 80s, so that might really put pressure on the main event, but it should hopefully deliver. This was co-main, which was a tag team matchup. It was about that had great heat and good wrestling, and actually done far better than I anticipated. It was the team of Shawn Spears and Hangman Page, who defeated Pac and Claudio Castingoli, so two champions, the World and TNT champions, in 1348, when Hangman Page pinned Claudio Castagnoli with the Adam's apple, thanks to a distraction from Cassie. Now, Cassie's, of course, they renamed, which she should have been at All Out, Peyton Royce, obviously. We know where her alliance is, but you can see there the great performances, Pac 98, Hangman 92, Shawn Spears and Claudio over 52 and 67, respectively. Still a very, very good tag team matchup, though, and that could have been evented, but still pleasantly pleased with it. Just a few negatives, but all good. Moving along, we then just had backstage, we had Shawn Spears take Cassie backstage. Obviously, Hangman's already there. They're joined by the Butcher and the Blade. And he just says, see, look who I've brought to AEW. I used to be the perfect 10. This is Cassie, the perfect 1. So a 59, and Hangman's posse just got a little bit stronger with a female within the ranks. And off to the main event we go. Cody versus Pentagon. It was an exceptional matchup. Cody gets the win over Pentagon in 1832 with a beautiful disaster. An 85 matchup. I'm really happy with that considering the colour commentary ruins the match again. Come on, Matt Stryker, please get good. 92 plays 84. And this was just a regular match, so happy with that. Negatives there, mostly from our commentary team. In the show, 83, popularity increased in 40 regions. I'm quite happy with that. We did move along a lot of storylines, started a few. And to be honest, because we've got such a stacked roster, there was quite a few that didn't even feature on the show that we'll need to squeeze in next week to make sure we can get them on the card for upcoming events. In the form, of course, of Fight for the Fallen and Knighthood. But I think that's a good thing. We won't, because obviously I don't have morale on for missing shows, because we saw WWE do it, you can rotate wrestlers, and obviously like lesser wrestlers were getting a bit of negative reaction for not making events. So I like the fact then we can rotate, we don't need to use every big name in every show, but try and mix them up with lesser talents just to try and get as many people over and see how we go. But anyway, Dynamite was fantastic reviews, NXT was great, Ring of Honor was excellent, so we're all fighting on the same night. Impact, I'm not going to extend Kira Hogan. Is that someone we'd look at? Possibly, she's only 27, there's a lot of good stats that could develop over time, but how much depth do we need in the women's division? Well, Tuna's out for a few weeks, and Priscilla, only going to be a few days, so she'll be fine. There's a new signing for you. We have actually managed to pinch Evie. Perfect. The currently known Dakota Kai. I know I keep pinching people from WWE, but there's some wrestlers you just have to get. And I feel like if I want the best women's division, somebody like Evie has to come in. So, absolutely. I'll go babyface just now. And we'll probably take the same kind of idea as she done in WWE and went heel, because she's someone that should have been babyface her life, went heel and was just incredible. This isn't great. He's been identified as a steroid user, and I can't even rehab him. Just need to find him. It's annoying. Oh, I also will try to get Kalisto. Now, the reason for him, I know it's another WWE guy, but he's actually left WWE back in September. Well, actually, a year ago. So we kept an eye on him, we shortlisted him. And this is one where he's basically been approached by, I believe, CMLL. So I felt like this was the opportunity to try and bring him in, just to give us more really good luchadors, and obviously extending the contract of the Blade, Mr. Pepper Parks. So I'll need to negotiate that Kalisto deal, make sure we can get him. Nick Jackson's relocated, and finally our Dynamite show was a 2.90, so good stuff there. But anyway, that's us. We are finished for today. I'm going to go for a wee lie down now and hopefully feel a bit better. But thanks for tuning in. As I say, hopefully we can just have some really good shows going forward, and yeah, let's make this the most unrealistic save ever. But thanks for watching. Take it easy, guys, and hopefully I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.